Welcome, here we are by a 2024 GMC Sierra 2500 HD. This one is the SLE package. It does have a couple extra convenience packages on it too. I'll get more to that in a minute. So this one is pretty nicely equipped. One of the nice things I like about it is the smoke black roof marker lights on it. It's part of that preference package. The LED running lights look great, and you gotta love the mean tough look at the front of these GMC HD trucks. They just have a ton of curb appeal, something that I really like. This one's equipped with the running boards. Of course, this is a double cab, as you can see. This is upgraded with the 20-inch wheels as well, which really may give this truck a nice look with the off-road tires. Looking in at the mirrors here, this one you have just your regular convex mirror and your side view mirror. Now on these GMC HD trucks and the Chevys as well, you can actually go give these a little yank and extend them out. Sends out about 6 inches if you are pulling a bigger trailer. That is something nice that it's built right in. And again, you just shove them right back in and they're back to your regular mold. Power folding mirrors for me are one of the things that I always feel are a must have on these trucks, just because the truck is already big, and if you're fitting in parking spots, it's a nice feature to have, or the garage or car wash or anything else. Yeah, going and folding and unfolding your mirrors manually. Looking inside the interior, you get with this jet black interior, you get a nice wood grain. On the passenger side here, we actually have two glove boxes that we can open up for some nice storage. This one, being the SLE package, does have the bench seat, which gives us some storage in the middle. You can also flip up the bench, and you get a nice locking storage that actually you have the old-fashioned key in your key you can lock here. It's a really nice feature if you got some valuables or if you carry a pistol, that type of thing. And then, of course, we got the beautiful dash that they put new in these 2024s. My front seats are pretty far back, so you can get a little view of the back seat area here. This one does have the under seat storage, which is basically just kind of a carpet divider here that gives you some extra room under the seats where you can hit the brakes and not worry about your jumper cables flying in at you. In the back seat, you do have a household outlet and two USB outlets, one of the newer ones that will actually charge quicker too, the USB-C. HD trucks all have this step here in the cab, which is really convenient for getting in and tying stuff down. This also has the fifth wheel and gooseneck prep package, so you can take a modular hitch and put it in and out. Very easy to install or uninstall. On the back side here, we do have the multi-gate tailgate. So on these, if you push the bottom button, think of that as opening the bottom part of your tailgate, and the top will fold down the top side here for you. So when you fold down just the top, you can have a little bit of a workstation. Work desk is one of the modes they talk about on it. Pull the whole tailgate down regularly. You can also pull your step here to be a nice little backdrop for you as well. And of course, the thing that makes the multi-gate famous is having it folded down where you get the step there. Now, it does give you a nice wide step, but really when you look at the side compared to where your bumper step is, you're only gaining about an inch or maybe two on step height, so it's not making a big difference for that. The nice thing is you have a little handle here you can flip up, hop, grab yourself when you're pulling in. Or even sometimes people have the step folded up here, and it gives you a lot closer access to the back of your tailgate or to the back of your truck when you're strapping stuff down or anything there. One of my main things that I like this multi-gate for is if I'm sitting tailgating, it's at about a perfect height to be a nice footrest for you. So it's one of the nice things if you're a tailgater on the truck. Got side marker lamps. Even the nice thing about GMC is they give you all these little touches where you can actually see that it lights up and says GMC there. It's GMC just is GM's best version of a truck. It just gets these little nice little notches above what you get on the Chevy. One other feature on the mirror here before we climb in, you do get your blinkers up there in your mirror, which is pretty neat. If you get into the higher trim levels, like in here, you would get some side lights for when you're reversing, you can turn on and off. So a couple things I'm gonna show you on the inside here. This one has our SLE convenience package. So that's gonna give you the 120 volt outlets in the back bed and inside the truck. Dual zone automatic climate control, 10-way power driver's seat, tilt and telescopic steering wheel, USB ports in the second row, LED fog lamps, and those roof marker lamps I pointed out. Then you get the heat package, basically gives you heated seats and heated steering wheel. Of course, you get remote start and some of your other features on there, like your theft deterrent system and rear window defogger. Those 20-inch wheels are a $1,400 option. And this also has a preferred package, which gives you adaptive cruise control, hitch guidance view, built-in garage door opener, the LED cargo bed lighting, that type of thing. So just to point that out real quick, when we're looking at LED cargo lighting, that is your LED lights here. So even if you got a tonneau cover on, it's going to give you lighting inside the truck. With that gooseneck package, those little pucks come out, you have spots to hook up either a gooseneck or a fifth wheel hitch, and you get your four prong and seven prong outlet there. This is where my 120 volt outlet comes in. It's a 400 watt, so not anything you're going to run real major stuff off of, but it's convenient to be able to hook up some things. So inside here, as I mentioned, you get 10-way power driver seat. Part of that's the lumbar. Looking in on the doors, again, got nice wood grain and speaker grates. These have push-button four-wheel drive. You see that this one has four low as well, and this gives me a couple different modes. And here's all my lighting controls for my bed lighting. I got fog lights right there, and gauge brightness, my other stuff. Everything has the electronic parking brake now, as opposed to the old foot one. Heated steering wheel. I can adjust my following distance on my adaptive cruise control, or if you don't have that feature in your truck, it will change how far away your forward collision alert is. Part of that is also that we have a camera and some of the other features here. It's up there and by your rearview mirror if you see it from the windshield. That gives me stuff like automatic high beams I can turn on and off with my button here at the end of my blinker stick. Forward collision alert, also lane keep assist that I can turn on and off right here. Will actually nudge your steering wheel if you start drifting out of your lane. So if you don't use your blinker, it'll get you using your blinker. You should use it anyways. I hate people that don't. Got fully digital gauges here. You can customize these things any way that you like. You can change to where it'd show your temperature on the one side, your compass, all sorts of things. Got the nice large touchscreen in this, a 14.4 inch. Absolutely nice system here. You see, it gives me huge navigation, gives me wireless Apple CarPlay, Android Auto, stuff like that. You can do some split screen stuff with it too, where you have it show your map on one side with your radio, or maybe you have your radio showing with your map being larger. You can see your trailer status and even do an old fashioned clock. So being this one's a diesel, it has the exhaust brake function there. Also my power tailgate release, hazard lights, and traction control. Got dual zone climate control on here. Right now I have it synced up, so when I move my driver's side, it does both sides. My passenger changes their temp, it automatically goes to sync to the dual zone, or I hit sync there again to sync it up. All the other stuff's pretty standard. Trailer brake controller is right here. So overall, just a really nice truck. On this one, being that it had the extra packages there too, there's where they call that the universal home remote. That's your built-in garage door opener and my slider window control for my rear window slider as well. So SLE is a very popular package in these trucks. Gives you a lot of bang for the buck. This one's stickering for $73,400 with a lot of must-have options that really makes you pretty comfortable and still getting that Duramax engine in there. 975 foot-pound of torque out of that Duramax, which is just awesome. So, and overall, just a gorgeous truck. Something that will last just forever. You take good care of it. And very good reason, that you see so many of these on the road. So, you guys get any questions or want me to detail some more features, shoot me a comment in the comments feed. Go ahead, like the video, and of course subscribe to the channel. I'm getting pretty close to where I'm up to the 500 subscriber goal, so definitely help me out. Hit that subscribe button. We'll see you guys next time.